I'm a minority. 1% of the world's population has red hair, which I do. 4% of that 1% have beautiful baby blue eyes, which I do. And 1% of that 4% are homosexuals, which I do.
My dad was a redhead.
Yeah.
And he always had a chip on his shoulder about it.
Really?
Oh, it breaks my heart.
But now, they're highly sexualized. I mean, you've got, used to be just Blue Kennedy.
Yeah.
Now there's James Jameson, Bennett Anthony. Like,
yeah.
Ginger porn stars are hot.
Right. Yeah.
So here's another great wave that you get to ride.
Right. Well, I'm not going to say I'm responsible for it.
Take the credit.
You know, to tap into the zeitgeist like that, it was a joke between Glenn Zumi and I when we were doing an interview like after 2011, and he said, "Are you ever going to go back and into Edinburgh?" I said, "If I do, I'm going to march hundreds of redheads through the street." And to just say it, and then I got the permission to do it, and then everybody showed up, and then that it just struck just as like this big article in the UK about a kid getting bullied. And his mom had to take him out of school, and it just started that topic, and it just exploded. And then Thomas Knights was just at the tail end as I was finishing, and he carried it off. There's another film called Being Ginger, and it just all just happened at the same time, so.
I love Lesbian 1 and 2. I couldn't imagine two better people to raise a Weasley in this post-Harry Potter world.
It's really interesting to be a part of something, like, And it's changed a lot. Like, as you said in Google, I don't have, when you type in Sean Hitchens, it's not gay comedian, it's ginger comedian.
Yes.
Yeah, and it's very interesting. And then the topic above, like, Prince Harry, he's sexualized. You have, the guy from Homeland, that sexy man, you know, being a redhead.
Outlander.
Yeah.
Whatever his name is, Sam Heughan.
Yep.
He's a huge sex symbol.
Oh, yeah.
And that's fascinating. It was always before redheads were comedians.
Yep.
You know, you had Carrot Top and...
Oh, yeah.
Who's now become a space alien.
Yeah.
And Conan O'Brien.
Yeah.
Even used to get a lot of mileage out of it.
Yeah.
I don't know if Louis C.K. does it so much.
Yeah. Women always sexualized. Redheaded women always sexualized.
Mm-hmm.
Redheaded men, Deliverance.
I have never had sex with a woman. Legend says that I was born with the umbilical cord wrapped around my neck, and I worked it like a boa.
You know, Deliverance. We're always the heck. We're always, you know, selling cereal as a kid and then playing the banjo when we're older. So it's kind of nice. I would love to see more ginger representation in, like, in mainstream, in movies, and it's just, you know, to see a male redhead, you know, it's kind of hot. It's hot. I don't know if I would do ginger on ginger. I'm still not there yet. I call it completing the circle of fire. I don't want to complete the circle of fire, but...
That might be a little too exclusive. You know,
yeah, like mirroring, like a theater exercise. Yeah.
But now, doing the gay coming out, because you know... Because you were at one point a gay comedian.
Yeah.
A comedian. Is it the process of ginger liberation the same as... as gay liberation?
Well,
but you don't really have to come out because it's already visible.
Right, you can't deny it. I think it has been a blessing. I don't want to ever poo-poo like being labeled a gay comedian. It did a lot for me. It gave me a lot of room to experiment and a lot of to form what I do with this show. It's really being embraced by everybody. And to like go to a place where you're not known, and then to have a diverse audience, gays, lesbians, old straight, you know, Scottish women, grandmas, kids in the audience, and to realize that the message of the show appeals to a lot of people, has been a real gift. Mm-hmm. So, I will happily own the title of Ginger until my hair falls out and it doesn't work anymore.
It's not easy for gay men to have a baby. No matter how hard we try with one another, it never results in a pregnancy. Masturbating in someone's house and getting away with it without them knowing is a hell of a lot easier than masturbating in someone's house while they're waiting for you to finish.
Did you ever go through a goth phase and want to dye it black?
No, I did. Here's the story. I did a production of Anna Green Gables at a summer stock, and
you weren't playing Anne.
No. So they cast me, and then I showed up for rehearsal, and they realized that there couldn't be two redheads in the Avonlea school. So they sent me to like the small town hairdresser, and she turned my hair jet black. And so I was the goth kid of Avonlea, because as soon as the lights hit my face, it was just like this whitewash with black hair. Yeah. That was the closest thing to a goth phase. Yeah. A musical.
Anna Green Gables. What's next?
I don't know. Alopecia? Alopecia rights?
There's that model.
Yeah.
Who's actually been doing that.
Yeah, it's, you know what, I love people like Tilda Swinton right now, because I feel, and I've always loved Tilda Swinton, but I feel like she's on the real edge of what's coming next in terms of, beauty, in terms of individuality, in terms of how we perceive. I find her so empowering, because I look at her and I see, oh, you look like me. And it inspires me to look at people like David Bowie, and I was like, oh, you look like me.
Yeah. The first time you hear you got a woman pregnant? I started crying at bank commercials, defending Nickelback.
Buddies, January...
22nd to the 24th, four shows. And you can join the gingernation.com.
Gingernation.com.
Yeah.
Do you have to be ginger? Or
no. It's open to anybody. Anybody with the tinge of gins or anybody. Anybody. Even if you don't have hair.
Yeah. Okay. And you're glad to be back at Buddies?
Yeah. It's nice. It's this whole year has been, because when I came back from Scotland, I went into a development phase with the show. And, you know, that sort of the last year has been very on the admin side and on the business side. So finally I get to like pick it up and say, oh, this is what this is all about, you know, all this work. So I'm excited to hit the stage and just to get the fuck out of my apartment.
There I will retrace my journey. I will play the bagpipes, and like the Pied Piper, I will call my spawn to arms. We will settle on a piece of crown land, and from outer space, it will look like an infestation of fire ants. Then, and only then, do we declare ourselves a sovereign ginger nation. All hail the Red Orchid Pale!
Yeah.
And how old is the kid, and is it ginger?
So she just turned 2. But I'm not going to tell you if she's ginger or not.
Oh, it's part of the show.
Yeah.
Okay. Then we'll all be there January 26th.
No, 22nd to the 24th.
24th.
Yeah.
At Buddy's.
Yep. Awesome.
Great.
Yay.